Hey guys, I'm building a neighborhood social application with the TomTom Maps APIs. It has to run on Android, iOS, and web. I could use React Native to do it, but I have decided to learn something new. That's why I'm using the Quasar framework. And in this video, I will show you how to add a map component into a Quasar application. Let's do some JavaScript. The first thing we need to check is, we have Node in our machine. Let me check the version here quickly. Once we check that, we install our TomTom SDK for web following the instruction from the developer portal. And once that is finished, we can install Quasar CLI, which is the command line interface, the recommended flavor of Quasar. Okay, that is done. Now we create the default project. I'll call it My Maps. If you need to know more about the options when creating the default project, check the Quasar documentation. I will leave a link in the description. And it's done. Let's see it live. We type Quasar dev. This will launch the web version of the application in developer mode so we can debug. And a new web browser tab will open. And I see it here. Let's take a moment to see what do we get with the default application. First, there is a left drawer menu. We will remove that in a moment. We have the Quasar logo centered in the main section of our layout. Here, we will place our TomTom map. And finally, I can see a header section. We will place the initial city name there. Opening the project in Visual Studio Code, we go in the source folder to check the main layout view page. Here, we have the visual objects we see now on the screen. I will start by removing the items for the left drawer menu. Changing the page title from the header and removing the Quasar version label on the right. And I think we are ready to start with our map component. Inside the index view page, we see where the Quasar logo comes from. It is displayed in the center of the main layout using the Flex Center CSS class. What we are going to do is to change this for our own map component. I will call it TomTom Map. And at the end, we want to add the city as a component prop, so we can select where should be the map center first. So let's declare this new TomTom Map component below. And add the import from the components folder. Of course, we haven't created it yet, so let's take this one we already have from the default application, Essential Links, and rename it for our purposes. Updating the name and removing the props and code that we don't need for now. Well, we know we need at least one prop, the city name. And for testing, let's display this text with the city that we pass. We can see now on the right side that our code is working. Now that we have a component, let's add the TomTom map object. First, let's change the div element that we have created and give it an ID, as usually we do in our previous tutorials. Now, in the mounted function, which is executed when the component is loaded, we are going to create the TTMap instance. This is the container. And here is our API key. Remember, you can get your own for free at developer.tomtom.com. And finally, don't forget to import the TT library. Now, that was easy, right? Now we need to make this map full screen. If we go back to our index view page, we see that the flex class is still set. Let's remove it. And back to our TomTom map component, let's add the Quasar CSS class window height, which will then adjust the size to use the complete area. And now that we are in this component, how about not hard coding the API key, but passing it as a prop? Let's do that. So whenever we use our component, we need to pass then the city and the API key. Much better. Now we're going to create the new component that will perform the search operation. For that, we go to the component folder. Let's call it search view. In the template section, let's add an empty div. I will add something to display a bit later. In the script section, let's name it TomTom search. This is the name we will use to add it to the map. For props, we already know we need at least two. One is the API key for the search operation, and the other one is the city name. We will pass this as the query for the fuzzy search. Now, when this component is mounted, we will call the fuzzy search API, passing these two values as options. Let's not forget to import the library. The fuzzy search API returns a promise, so when the response comes back, I'm going to display it in the console, so we can check where we can get the values we need for the map. Oh, I mentioned that we want to display something. In the data function, we return a placeholder text, so the user knows we haven't got any results yet. Let's go back to the empty div in the template and display a H4 text with the city name, which is now a placeholder. Back in the TomTom map component, we can add the search component inside the div that contains the map. Let's not forget to add the props values as keys, the API key and the city. Now we can import the search component as TomTom search and add it to the list of components we are going to use in this one. Once we do that, we see that the search component is mounted and the placeholder is visible on top of the map. Let's check the response we got from the API in the console. I see we got the default 10 results from the search query. The first one is the one with the higher ranking. Expanding it, we see the position coordinates we need for the map location and the address to replace our placeholder text with city and country name. And back again in the TomTom map component, I'm going to add an event handler that will receive the new center location after the search operation. Let's call it cityFound. And the handler function handlerSearchResult. Let's place it inside the methods object from the component. And we expect a location as a parameter, right? This location is where the map is going to be centered, so let's move it slowly there and let's change the zoom to 16. Now, in the search component, when we get a response from the search API, we emit the event cityFound, sending the coordinates of the first result we got. And now we can update the placeholder text with the city name and country. Note that the name is in the freeform address field. And I need to use the correct object to launch the event and change the name since we are inside the anonymous function that handles the response. And also let's fix this typo here in the map component. Now the event is triggered and handled correctly, and we see the map center in Berlin. If we want to try another city, we need to go back to the index view page and simply change the city name property. How about Madrid or Austin, Texas? Or Portland? Very neat, eh? Check the code in GitHub. I have left the link in the description below, and let us know if you like it in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching, and happy mapping!